So welcome you guys, come on in. We're a group of avid food security neighborhood building gardeners. And we have a mission to offer everything for free to Anchorage gardeners so that they can become more food secure and more neighborhood secure and turn Anchorage back into a small town. Katherine's is the coach at Fairview
Valley.
So we have coaches in almost all neighborhoods. I think we're missing three or four. We don't have any in Girdwood, so if you're from Girdwood, I wanna talk to you. Good. This is what Anchor Gardens looks like now. I'm gonna pass that around. This is our network, and when you press that little thing, it sends you to the join thing, so we can map out where all the gardeners live. Who are the beginners, who are the experts, and how we can connect them together, especially in their own neighborhoods. So I'll let you see what this looks like. When you join, you get on this map, and it's free. We're not collecting your email. Don't put a junk email in. A lot of people are doing that because then you don't get the newsletter and you don't get all the stuff that's going on in all of our backyards and sharing with our neighbors. So there, with that, you're set. Thank you for doing this.
Yeah. Oh, you're welcome. Yeah. Well, I started winter sowing 2 winters ago, so this will only be the third year I've done it, so there's lots of experimentation that still needs to be done, you know, and a lot to learn still. But one of the reasons I started doing it is I live in a small house, and I wanted to start starts for a lot more food than would fit in my small house. I mean, I would set up shelves and grow lights and like grow hundreds of seeds, and my partner and I would be like walking through little aisles in the house and didn't have room to do the other things we like to do too. So I read about winter sowing, and the first winter, and I'll have this graphic that I'll pass around that just outlines the steps. It's an easy process, and you can take a photo of it on your phone. But the first year I did it, I still started things inside and did winter sowing too in case it didn't work. I didn't want to be left with nothing. And the winter sown things weren't as large as the ones that I had started inside earlier, but they caught up quickly and were more robust and produced better than the stuff that I had started inside. They were just acclimated to the conditions like from the beginning. So, with that, we'll start in. I prepped some jugs. Oh, go ahead.
I just had to add something. I was talking to Sarah Bean just a couple summers ago, and she said that she doesn't even start broccoli inside anymore because it's so much slower than the ones that she starts right in the ground because they're adjusted.
Good to know. So I prepped some jugs beforehand because I didn't want to bring, like in the bottom, I just used like my hot glue gun to melt the holes, and I didn't want to bring a bunch of utility knives for people having to saw everything. Well, I don't have a bunch. So
thank you.
This part has been done for you. And the next part is just filling the soil. And I brought some soil. Hopefully there's enough for everyone. And the soil that you use is important. You don't want to use seed starting mix because it doesn't have nutrients in it. You want to use soil that has nutrients. I really like Happy Frog for starting. That's what this is. And I've also used Pro Mix and compost from my compost, but I just didn't get around to like getting any compost before everything froze. So this year I bought Happy Frog. And so you want to make sure that your soil is nice and moist. And you know, for the winter sowing, the soil is wetter than I would do it if I were starting it in the house. And I don't know what the reason for that is. I don't know the science behind that, but the people that I learned from online, that's what they said they do. And so that's what I did, and it works.
So when you kind of take the soil and you squeeze it, you know, normally it's like you shouldn't have anything.
You don't want it so wet that you still don't want water to drop out. Yeah. So not quite that wet. So I guess what should I do this? Should I pass the bucket of soil around, I guess? I'll go ahead and put some in here. And more water may need to be added as we go around. Bucket around this way. And if it starts to get kind of dry, let me know. We have a little water right here. Yes. This sheet here, it says 2 to 3 inches. I think 3 to 4 inches in Alaska is better, just because when we get to the where we have a lot of fluctuations in temperature in the spring, then it holds the heat a little bit better. Naturally, this one could use a little bit more soil, but I won't put more in because I don't know. I want to make sure there's enough for everybody. So.
We played this game before.
And I guess we'll go ahead and plant our seeds so that they don't get lost, and then we'll talk about what kind of seeds are better.
So all of these are good.
Oh yeah, I just brought things that I know will work.
So all the ones that she brought are good to use. So some of you were waiting because you didn't know which ones would be good. All these are good.
Yeah. And also keep in mind, if you don't have success this year, doesn't mean you won't have success in the future, even doing the same thing.
Oh, no.
But So one thing that I read, I've always planted the seeds according to what the seed packet says, but I recently read where, Cheryl Mann, who used to live up here and now has all kinds of YouTube videos on winter sowing, she says to not plant them as deeply as the seed packet says. But I personally haven't done that, and I've had, and my success has been good. But that's something to keep in mind if for some reason you don't have good success. Just be sure not to plant them too deep. Don't plant them any more deep than what the package says. So err on the side of shallower if you're not sure. And so depending on how big your plant is going to be and how soon you're going to put them in your garden, I tend to not get to them to transplant into my garden until like later than I should. So I leave more space for them to grow before I transplant. So like for this, for broccoli or cabbage or cauliflower, I would put like 3 in here. If you know that you'll be getting to them sooner, you can put more. But then again, that's all personal choice, experimenting, seeing what works for you. So let's see, I think I will plant some broccoli. And this says 1/4 inch deep. Yeah, so go ahead and plant your seeds. If you're not sure how deep to plant, you can look at the package or I can let you know what the package says. The broccoli is 1/4 inch deep. cabbage quarter inch deep. Nasturtiums are deeper. Nasturtiums are half an inch.
One kind of a rule of thumb that I use is however big the seed is, that's how deep it goes.
Oh.
That's my rule of thumb.
And people were asking about what seeds are better than others to do with winter sowing. Basically, anything that you need to start really early indoors in order for it to mature and get a vegetable or fruit by the end of the season, you would want to continue to do that, starting it inside rather than winter sowing.
Do you know if any of the recycle places that like collect jugs where you can get them from if you don't have jugs?
I know we could like reach into the bins and grab them. You can go to coffee shops and ask. They're usually really happy to give you their jugs.
I don't go through a lot of like gallons of milk. And
right, I don't either. Yeah, I've gotten them all from people I know.
Yeah.
Yeah, but other seeds that do good up here, Alaska perennials, you know, do good up here. If you want to do flowers or a perennial herb, and things that need stratification. All the cruciferous vegetables I've tried have done well up here.
Just in terms of collecting jugs, you can also reach out to a lot of the local businesses in town. They'd be more than happy for you to offload them. Just be really consistent. A lot of like the little coffee shops and stuff, like all they're doing is smushing them and throwing them away a lot of times.
Yeah.
So if you say like, hey, could you save me like a dozen jugs? Most of them would be more than happy to do it for you.
Yeah.
So like, yeah, I would absolutely. Say that's a good one, is just like reaching out to some of your local businesses that are in your area and just being like, hey, I really need some of these for a craft project. And they are almost always more than happy to set some aside for you in a bag or whatever.
Yeah. Just make sure you go back and get them.
Yes. Because otherwise they won't do it again. They'll be like, I will not help you this time.
Yeah. But, and other seeds that I'm going to experiment for the first time with this year, people have said, no, you can't do root vegetables, you can't do carrots. Actually, I have done beets, and those do really well. You can't do carrots or parsnips. But you can, if when you're transplanting them, that you don't tear them apart, if you just, you know, prepare a hole the size of your container and transplant the whole thing. Then you're not disturbing the roots. And, yes, I did. And those I did like transplant. But this year I'm not. I mean, it'd just be easier just to leave them in there and the whole deal over.
The whole piece of plastic?
No, you take it out of here. Yeah. So the next step after you have your seeds planted is to water them in. And generally I have a different type of watering thing that I use, but I couldn't find it. So just, if you have a watering can with a sprinkle, that works better than this. But this is what I have. And this is also good for if you need to, I'll get to there later, but if you need to water it after it's all closed up. Yeah, we're making a mini greenhouse.
Have you ever planted?
Those need to be started much earlier. Yeah, so they wouldn't be good for winter sowing. Yeah. So, and one way to tell, you can like look at the back of the seed packet where it says how many days to maturity.
So onions are like 100 days or 12.
Yeah. Well, green onions may be fine, you know, that spring onions.
When you talk about stratification, did that mean that you might have an early set of, say you did 10 broccolis and you put the 10 broccolis out and then
you started some later so that those, is that what you meant?
No, stratification are seeds that have to go through a cold period in order to germinate. So, yeah. So this is the perfect cold period, sitting them out in the snow after they've been sown. So that would be succession planting.
Okay.
Yes. And if you want to do that, I mean, these are what you do in here. I mean, they're going to come up pretty much the same time as soon as the conditions are right. But you could, if you want a succession plant, I mean, you could sow some things, some winter sowing in here, and then direct sow some things once your soil in your garden isn't frozen anymore. Because my things sprout when the soil in my garden is still frozen. Mm. So
where do you put that?
So, yes. So then the next step, you get your seed in, you get it watered, then you close up your little greenhouse with duct tape. And there's duct tape on, well, there's not duct tape on that table, but we'll all share. And you want to make sure that you have a good seal. You know, you don't want leaks, except in the top. And I have learned that you need good quality duct tape to last through, like, the freeze-thaw cycles. This red one isn't very good quality. I'm just using it to demonstrate. But this is the next step, is like creating your greenhouse.
There's holes in the bottom.
And you'll notice that I put a number one on the jugs. On the sheet, it says to write what you planted on there. But if you want to use the jug again, I mean, and you don't want to plant the same thing, so I just number mine and I make a, make a spreadsheet of what's where. So you only need one.
They do.
You don't want it. So you have to use a specific marker. But I will not put the marker in here. You want to use garden markers, which you can get at Millie Feed. Permanent Sharpies will fade. What are called garden markers, and it also actually says on the marker, you know, will not fade in the sun. And also paint pens. I've never used paint pens, but that's what a lot of people say works for them. Oh, yeah, I would imagine that would work. Yeah. Yeah, and make sure you have it watered well before taping it up. If you didn't, then you can always.
Oh, this spray foam is here.
The weather starts to become feasible for that. And once you have germination, I mean, if you don't have condensation, if you don't see condensation on the walls of your little greenhouse, then you'll want to give it water. I mean, there's drainage, so I mean, if there's too much water in there, it'll come out, or it should if they don't get clogged for any reason. That's a question that I'm not sure how to precisely answer. If anybody else has an idea, what was that?
Not dry.
Right, you don't want it to be dry.
So where do I put this? Do I put it on top of a stove?
Yes.
Thing, so, or next to the house where it's
never. And in fact, I was going to take a photo of mine in a snowbank. I'll pass it around. Yeah, so once you're done, let me pull this up. Once you're done, put them out in the snow. And I even like,
oh my gosh,
I even like dig a little spot. Okay, I don't have the camera to see that. I even dig a little spot in the snow so that the wind won't blow it over or won't get kicked over. And before the seeds germinate, it's unlikely that it will dry out because you have a hole in the top and snow will go in, that rain will go in. So that helps with the process. So then another thing to be aware of. Oh, do you need some tape?
I'm gonna wait.
Okay, sounds good. Another thing to be aware of, the jugs that I showed you out in the snow, we had a really warm day and I wasn't home and some of them tipped over because the snow melted from underneath them and the soil got all shook up inside, and so the seeds were no longer at the correct depth. I did still get like one seedling come up in one of those jugs. But yeah, so when you place, you can place them out, you know, in an area that will get lots of sun, but make sure that won't happen. I've gone out in the wintertime sometimes and have just piled up more snow around them. And another thing to watch for, when we start, you know, our days are getting a lot longer, and when we have those huge temperature shifts, you know, where we have the nice warm days and then it's like 30 degrees colder at night, you don't want premature germination. You know, you want to make sure that we're not speeding up the process of germination in these necessarily. We are a little bit, but not dramatically. So you want to make sure that they're not going to germinate and then we get weather in the teens again. So kind of keep an eye out on what your area, well, you know, you're in your areas probably like, I'm not sure how to say what I'm saying.
Microclimates. Yeah.
Well, yes, those, but I guess it's something you learn from trial and error when you should actually, when things should be growing outside or not.
Does that help temper the fluctuations because it's kind of an insulator?
Yeah, it is an insulator. Yeah, so that's helpful with that. And then if you do have sprouts, if you do have germination, and you do get one of those out of the blue, really cold nights, just put some blankets over them. And the soil, you know, instead of having 2 or 3 inches of soil, having 3 or 4 inches of soil will just help keep everything warm through that cold snap, and they should be fine. I think that's it.
We've gotten a lot of snow, so obviously it's going to take a bit for us to probably find our gardens or anything outside. So is it still okay, like, obviously at one point if this is, like, ready to be transplanted, but you can just use it itself, correct? Like, so if I still can't find a garden to transplant it to make it grow bigger, then you can just use kind of what you have in it.
Yeah, if for some reason we have a really late spring,
yeah,
and but your things have gotten bigger, but your garden is still frozen, you could transplant them up to a bigger pot.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I've never had to do that, but yeah, that's definitely something that could be done.
It seems like right. Everything's shoveling too. So.
Right, yeah. Yeah. But the seeds might not germinate while they're sitting. And that's another reason you keep putting snow around them. You know, if you don't want premature germination.
I did this last year. I just want to explain that I did it late, and I took them and I put them in my greenhouse, and the watermelon did really well seeding up from that, so that I could just transplant it into the. But they stayed. So Elliot Coleman says 500 miles for every extra layer of plastic you have in your greenhouse. You go 500 miles south. So think about that and how your zones work if you get that. So yeah, so I experimented in the greenhouse. Lots of things came up in these jugs before. They would have if I would have just planted them in the greenhouse. So yeah.
Yeah, and if you're lucky enough to have a greenhouse, you can try some of those vegetables that do need a longer growing period in order to produce.
The other thing I did, we have a dark sauna, and it's very cold in there. And so I did all my seeds and left them in the sauna until it was time for them to come out. So that was also successful. So I'm feeling, it was only 1 year, so I'm feeling good about that, but don't take my word for it.
And another thing I really like about this is spring is always so busy, and it's nice to have some of the things planted like way beforehand.
If you get behind, you don't have to spend a whole bunch of money getting somebody else's.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Late frost. You know, a lot of these things can take a little bit of frost. You know, they don't mind their noses being nipped a little. But, you know, you can always cover them up with something, you know, to protect them from the frost. So, yeah.
Okay,
I think we got it. I think we did. I don't know where it is.
It's right over here.
Oh, this one?
Oh, yeah. Did I get to the last one? Talk about it all. Oh, when to open your jug.
Oh, oh yeah.
I knew there was something that
when the comes. We're all just going to have jugs. We're going to be so proud. We're like, we got it. We're here.
That's what we do. Well, and a nice thing too with this is, you know, they're pretty much already hardened off.
Yeah.
Yep. Mm-hmm. So you're not carrying stuff in and out. But you know, when the danger of frost has passed, you know, go ahead and open it up. I mean, by then, like in the picture, your sprouts will be, you know, they'll be pretty big. Some of them might even be coming up out of the hole here. Yeah, just open it up. Join. There's so much good information on the Facebook page.
Yeah,
Anchor Garden.